Welcome back to East Haven County, where we are continuing the development of Fort John, the county's seat and biggest city. Oh yeah, we finally have it named after not one, but two votes in which Fort John was the obvious preference from you guys. Now in the most recent episode, we developed the first real inner city area of the city, and today's episode is going to be quite a big one, as we're adding more inner city developments, but also some industry and focal points. It is a nice, if slightly overcast, day here in East Haven County with lots of commuter traffic going on. So we've just developed the district of Windsor, Inner Windsor and Emerson Park, and these districts kind of have this tricky transitional phase where we try to go from row house developments to what will eventually be high density here in downtown. And of course, we can now name it Downtown Fort John. Very nice. Today we're developing Coleridge, which is going to have sort of a similar vibe to Windsor. We're going to try to make it unique, of course. But the reason I also want to do some industrial stuff up here is not only is it fun and looks cool, it's going to add a more complete aesthetic to Fort John. And remember, you know, the city is supposed to have a massive industrial heritage. It's also a matter of statistics. The financial situation is looking very nice right now, at least. But our job count has kind of stagnated at around 12,000 while we've added in more people, which means that if I just minimize this and we check unemployed, we're sitting at around 2,000 unemployed people, and this is expected to rise. Now you may wonder, why can't we just provide these workplaces in Coleridge? Well, I think it's a matter of the composition of the area, because if Coleridge is going to look just slightly similar to Windsor, which it probably is, Windsor added more than 2,000 people, but only 850 job positions. So we're not likely going to provide the amount of jobs we need just by developing Coleridge, unless we turn it very officey, and I don't want that, hence the industry need. I've also made sure to rename the custom train station we have here to Fort John Central, at least for now. And then I've named all the lines we have going Fort John to Chowder Bay, Fort John to West Point, Fort John to Boston through Chowder Bay. And efficiency is looking good, and we're actually seeing quite a few people waiting here at the custom station, which is very, very nice. One little change I am going to make before we continue is I need to demolish this building here that's causing a host of trouble. Someone suggested I get the mod that adds prop versions of all the buildings so that I can just add that, and I think I might do that because I kind of want that building placed there, but I don't want it to be functional because obviously that caused some issues. All right, so how do we make Coleridge stand out from Windsor? Well, I think something we could do is just continuing on the trend that we already see here in Coleridge, because we have quite a few services as well as like educational establishments. We have the Fort John Children's Musical School, the Fort John Fire Department's main firehouse here, as well as the Fort John Police Department First Precinct Station. And we have this massive Coleridge Elementary School, and we're right next to the Fort John General Hospital. So there's a bit of a theme going on here in Coleridge where there's a very high density of service providers. So if we just continue that, education is probably the way to go, because that is very much going to continue making Coleridge distinct. Because if we check Windsor, it's pretty much just housing as well as businesses, you know, and a park and a bit of landscaping. But otherwise, it's pretty barren of services within the actual district. If we go by education, I think something we could provide is like this city high school here. At least if I open my elementary tab, it's looking pretty bad. We definitely need to do some investments here, and we have a pretty good hourly surplus, but the total cash reserve is pretty bad. I mean, this high school is going to be 300k, and ideally I also want to build the first college here in Coleridge, and that's 400k. So I think I'm going to have to take a loan. I think I'm just going to pause the game, and then we're going to place this high school first. So if we insist on not altering the road layout here in Coleridge, we have a couple of blocks available to us for placing the high school. And I think I'll go for this one because I kind of imagine that this southern triangle here in Coleridge is going to be like a really, really dense row house district, which I also think would be fitting right next to the school, which kind of makes me lean towards this block here. So the question is whether we align it to the avenue out here so that it's raised above much of the city, or we kind of place it alongside Sterling Street here and we have, you know, some terraforming and some landscaping in the back. I think we're going to place it alongside Sterling Street, and I need to fit in a bit of parking as well. So I'm going to try and just place it here without having any fancy placement method. There is a bit of parking back here, which I think we could get working. But I do also see a few issues here, as you guys can probably see with some of the like the landscape we have here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna add this little stop here just to get a bit of an extra node placed. Then I think we're gonna upgrade this part of Cozy Street to a key, as well as this part of Mulberry Street. And that looks a little better. It allows the building to kind of flatten the terrain and this parking lot to look a little better as far as functionality goes, at least. So I'll try and delete the lane here, and that also made sure that this surface actually looks good. It doesn't look like there's like a parking basement attached to the college here, sorry, the high school here, just this small stretch of surface parking. So I think it would be in order for us to just add a tiny bit of extra parking, just for good measure. Not a lot, there are plenty of parking opportunities alongside most of the public streets in the near vicinity, but I think just adding that bit of extra parking without doing too much detailing or anything is going to kind of help address the issue just a little bit. And this also leaves a bit of space for either adding some, a small park, something like that, or alternatively adding some developments. And I think we're gonna go for some development, because I think we can easily just squeeze in a bit of development here. We might even be able to zone it. Let's give that a go. Let's just get in some mixed use here on the corner, and then we should be able to use the path here to make it a little easier for us to just get some row housing in there as well. So I'm just gonna go like this, and then I think we'll add in a key segment here so that it faces towards Garnet Street. At least a stretch of it faces towards Garnet Street. What we can do is add a road here so that we face both streets. Yoink and yoink, and yeah, we can even get a corner lot going here, it seems. So let's just try and let this develop. And while we let this build, we can just grab in a quick little row house here with the bigger tool and just kind of squeeze that in. Wonder if I can I need to use anarchy, but I can pretty much just snap to this segment here. And that is going to just help densify it a little bit. So it's not fully zoned. There's a bit of a tweak in there, but otherwise it's pretty good. We'll make sure to add in a big tree here, maybe two, just to kind of cover up that area, and then get a few trees back here as well. And a few stain decals should just kind of help round this area out. And that's a pretty quick, easy high school. Looks reasonably detailed, didn't take a long time to make. And if you remember from the previous episode, Coleridge is actually named for the Cole family, specifically Mr. William Henry Cole. So I think we're gonna call this the William H. Cole High School. So it looks like enrollment is a little slow, but starting to pick up. And I guess with a bus system, which we will need within too long, this might improve further so that more people can actually commute easily to the William H. Cole High School. Now, for the small college, we are out of money. I mean, I guess we could kind of cheese it and just wait it out until we have the cash needed, because I'm making an obscene amount of money an hour right now. Alternatively, we could take what I think is the very first loan I've ever taken in Cities 2. What if we grab 300k? So that's a 2.8% interest rate, which doesn't seem like a lot. I mean, that should barely change my hourly income. And it barely did. Damn, I'm a fan. This is a money printing machine. This feels very American, actually. I'm a big fan of this situation. I guess the lack of debt doesn't look American, but otherwise, I need to remove some roads. I know I said I didn't want to, but if we actually grab the small college here, we can see that with the current road layout here in Coleridge, there's nowhere to put it. And I kind of wanted to reserve this southern area here for a dense row house neighborhood, like I mentioned. So I think I'm going to remove some roads here. We're going to remove this one. We're going to remove this one. Then let's grab Barlow Lane and just kind of drag this through right by the police station. And then this segment here where Willow Lane intersect with this major avenue, I think we're gonna make sure there isn't a crossing here. So if I disallow left turns like this, then there should be lots of traffic flow here without issues. And now we actually have this, like, it's almost like a super block, which we should easily be able to fit in our small college. Ideally, I want to place the college and then maybe kind of attach a more modern building that's going to look like a bit of an extension. So I think the actual college building, I might actually orient that towards... Is that going to be Sterling Street, just to get a bit of an angle here? I think I'm going to do that, actually. And then I need some sort of modern office building that I can kind of fuse together here to look like a, yeah, like I said, a modern extension. So let's just go into buildings, and office buildings is probably our best bet. And we might just go for this Coda Park, one of the signature buildings. Very modern, sleek design. So the question is whether I want the building to be directly fused into the structure of the old college, or as a separate structure and then try and connect it with like a sky bridge of some sort. And I think I like the sky bridge idea the most. So I'm gonna try and place it here. There's a bit of a clipping here with some of the parking, so we're gonna use better bulldozer to get rid of at least a few of these hitches here. But otherwise, this looks all right. We might even have space for additional parking here. Then there's something with the colors here that is a little odd. I think ideally I want to maybe, can I make this more white, basically? So that's the bottom segment there. And then I guess this is the actual structure. Oh, actually, it's this part. Okay. Well, let's actually just... I'm gonna grab this color scheme and try and apply it here. And I guess that looks all right. We're gonna use better bulldozer to get rid of these signs, though, because, I mean, this is like a modern extension to the college. So I don't want all these commercials and ads here for private companies. But otherwise, maybe I should remove this sub element as well. We can fuse these surfaces together, and then I kind of need to look for some kind of prop that can work as the sky bridge between these two buildings. Okay, so I've searched through the props, and I have a wacky idea and a slightly less wacky idea. Let's start with the less wacky one. So that would be using the covered pedestrian bridge here, elevating it like 10 meters, and basically just this remove snapping, and maybe just do a connection to this window here and just do like that. I mean, I kind of think that could work. You know, this window here kind of works as a door, and the same with the window over here. We can always like change the positioning a little bit, but I kind of feel that works. Something else we could try is to grab this train passenger car here, or maybe this one. Maybe this old school version here is a better fit than this one. So let's just grab this one, and then I'm gonna try this. And I'd love some feedback from you guys on what you feel about this solution here. But I mean, if I can just add it in so that we can't see the actual like wheels or whatever they are called for a train cart, I assume it's wheels. And if I can just kind of align this something like this, maybe like this actually. Oh, this is getting a little tricky, I admit. Maybe like this, actually. And we zoom out a bit, then, I mean, from a distance, I guess that could work. Does this have, this actually has a color palette as well, so if I colorize it to be a little more fitting, then maybe that works, or maybe we just keep the both of that. Let me know in the comments. I know this is a little crazy, but I think the glossy aluminum is sticking out a little much, so we're gonna try this train car instead. I mean, it's still kind of weird and funky, but I think it's a little less weird, maybe. So I'm just gonna try and once again just kind of get the alignment correct here and seeing if we can just squeeze that in. And I'm just gonna check if I can apply the same color scheme, and I actually can. So I think this looks a little better. It's still weird. I still want some feedback. Just trying out some things here. And while we are on the topic of feedback from you guys, I need suggestions for a proper name for this college. I've just called it Fort John Community College for now, but that is very much a placeholder we can change if you guys have some interesting suggestions. Enrollment is looking pretty good. We've surpassed 200, so that's very nice. But I really think we need to jump into a bit of detailing. We might need a bit more parking, and we definitely need to kind of extend these services and remove some of the hitches here so that this whole structure looks a little better integrated with the actual odd size of the block here. No crazy detailing or anything, but I think it's much better integrated with the block now. So let's just use the better bulldozer to get rid of the existing trees here, because they were at like a very early growth stage. And I think having a nice big old trees here is going to be more fitting, especially these oaks here. At least the original college building here is obviously quite old, so I think it would make a lot of sense to get these in. We'll mix in some London planes as well, but otherwise I don't think we're gonna add much more detailing than that. Kind of want to keep it relatively simple. We've got a lot of ground to cover today. I'll also add some decals, of course, because that's just going to add that extra bit of detailing, grabbing these 2K large decals by Sully and being pretty generous with how we're adding these throughout. All these custom surface paths definitely deserve some people walking alongside them. So we are gonna grab the invisible pedestrian path, not 10 meters of elevation though. Can we enable, I already have markers enabled, very good. So let's just get these added so that you can, so that we can see people travel all around the college structure here. That's going to be very, very nice. Make it all lively and stuff. Then we're going to finalize with these fantastic tire marks, also from Sully. Just gonna make the whole thing that much better. So with the college completed, I want to create like a, you know, a sort of a municipal administration building, some office building where most of the headquarters of the different service branches here in East Haven County reside and have most of their office staff. We have a big empty half segment of this block here. So I think if I just Maybe if I just move the police station a little bit, we could squeeze in maybe a 6x6 building. And what we are looking for is something big and boring. So let's see, we'll go for some high density, and I think we'll just go into the 6x6, and I need to find something boring, maybe even one of the hotel or motel buildings, because they rarely ever spawn when we zone it, so that would make sure that the building is kind of unique, right? Let's just see what options we have. So there's a level 2 6x6. I mean, wow, look at this. This is boring. And you just imagine handling people's boring cases in a building like this. Oof. So I'm just gonna try and see if this is a perfect fit or if it needs adjustment. So we're just placing it. That's so boring. All right, so I think better bulldozer, remove some of the bushes here. See if I can remove some of them individually. I can. Don't need to remove everything, because otherwise this asset almost perfectly lines up with the borders here of the police, the first precinct building. So that's pretty much a perfect fit. I want to remove all these signs as well, all these advertisements. They might respawn when a company actually moves in here, but I'll just remove them again. But yeah, this is pretty... what is this? No. Way too fancy. Let's get rid of this patio or whatever you call it. Now we have our municipal offices. That is one boring building, but I think it's such a nice fit here in Coleridge. With a few decals, just to make it a little more boring, dull and drab, she's gonna be absolutely perfect. Oh, actually, could we apply this stuff up here, maybe? Make it a little more rundown. I mean, this is not really what the county prioritizes to spend money on, so we'll just have some stains here on either side of the building as a nice little touch. So I would say at least half of Coleridge's current footprint is now occupied by service buildings or, you know, county offices and stuff like that. Let's offset that a bit by getting a bit of housing in here. So I think the row house project out here is something I want to get going with. And I kind of want to break up the zoning here by having an additional very small lane, which I think would be really fitting. We might even go for some sort of one-way configuration, something really small, such as the setup I'm using here. So maybe this one actually, so that we have a sidewalk. I think that would be fitting, and it's still sufficiently narrow. So let's move up here and see if I can get this to work. I'm gonna disable snapping, and then I think I want to branch out from... Do I want to branch out from here, or maybe just move straight up from here and then make a sharp turn? I might actually try to just do this, and we'll go to about here, and then I need to enable the curve tool so that we can get a really gentle curve going to about this point, and then connect it up to the main avenue here. And I don't do I actually want this? So what I think I'll do is I'll add in an additional road right about here. And then for this segment here, I don't want an actual intersection. And we're going to remove the stoplight. We're going to remove the crossings. And I think that's fine. And I don't want you to be able to turn left here or left here. So we have a continuous flow here. So if you want to go left here, you'd just go down Willow Street instead. Take that route. But the road layout here is a little weird. I will give you that. But this did enable a bit more zoning for us. So I'm hopeful that we can just zone this and that it's going to look all right by doing so. I kind of want to explore zoning as much as possible, even though this is a pretty detailed city. You guys know this. I have my reasons. It's easy, and I think we can usually make it work quite well, actually, even though it's obviously not perfect. It's not perfect compared to actually placing everything manually. but it does take a lot less time. And I think I'm just also trying to practice, like getting good at like zoning things, trying to manipulate the road layout to get zoning to work is a pretty good trait, I guess, a pretty good skill to have in Cities 2, since we are still bound to this, I guess I'm gonna be a little cheeky and call it legacy zoning system that we're still using here in Cities Skylines 2. So yeah, that's a big speech for me being lazy, I guess, but no, I mean it, I really want zoning to kind of work, so we'll see how this actually pans out. While we let this little tiny row house area develop, we're gonna do the same we did over in Winter, which is creating some sub-districts so that we can name these small sub-districts individually. So this is obviously part of Coleridge and the statistics and service coverage of Coleridge, but it's also its own little area, sort of like we see in some of the Manhattan districts in real life. So if you have a suggestion for what we're actually going to call this small historic row house district, a bit of a backstory, please let me know. I think a Daffodil Downs, man, that doesn't really work. Daffodil doesn't work either, but I think it's a placeholder for now. And things are starting to develop. And oh man, look at the elevation here. That's just pretty crazy. Yeah, that's a little crazy. But I'm hopeful the trees are gonna cover it up sufficiently so that this area looks all right. But it is a bit of a placeholder. It might need some change. Whoa, it already needs some changes. We're gonna grab this node here. And we're gonna lower that's for sure, because that looked a little weird. And then we'll probably lower some of the row houses here alongside the small street here. I don't mind that there's a bit of a way up to them, because maybe they were probably built before the car became, you know, the such a common method of transportation. But I think something like this is probably a little better. I think we'll do just a tiny bit of detailing by adding some hitches up here, because this is very, very steep, which I don't mind. That's a lot of character to Fort John as a city, that we have so many elevation changes. But I think just getting that added in is probably a good idea. And then we're going to use some bushes to just kind of cover up bits of the cliffside here. Not completely. I really like the map theme here, where we have some exposed rock in place. I think that looks really great, but yeah, we can never have enough bushes and trees to kind of cover up our imperfections and all that good stuff. Getting a fat oak boy placed right there, and maybe some London planes here alongside the road. I added in those final stain decals, and I think that's about it. But yeah, Daffodil is very much a placeholder. But the same can be said for Inner Winter and Emerson Park, where I asked you guys for feedback and suggestions for what to actually name these places. And before I rename them based on the wonderful feedback from you guys, I need to do a little change here in Emerson Park, because I have a surprising amount of skate enthusiasts among my crowd, which is really awesome. So yeah, the tiles I put here to the skate park, it's not gonna work, is kind of what I get. And then there's a point to be made about the graffiti here on the actual ground. No graffiti artist would, I mean, this is probably not a very common thing, so I'm just gonna get rid of that as well, as you guys commented on that as well. I'm gonna keep the graffiti. This is tricky. Can't select just the graffiti. I'm gonna keep the graffiti or the weird stickers we have here on the side of this little ramp here, but otherwise I'm gonna need a different surface texture altogether. But I do want this surface to look interesting also from a distance, so I'm gonna find one of these colored tile sets, and I think I'm gonna grab this maybe this dark red one, or should we grab the yellow set? Actually, that might look very interesting with the yellow set. So let's just try and put this surface onto this skate park here. And then I'm probably gonna have to use even more like stain decals than I've used up until now, just to make it look a little more beaten up, you know, because I imagine whatever this is, a thick layer of paint or whatever it is. You know, it's probably pretty beaten up by now from all the skateboarding usage. So let's get some stain decals, see if we can kind of squeeze them in here. This is maybe a little much, but something like this, and then some of these large ones here to just kind of cover up this whole thing. I imagine this is pretty well used by now. Let's start by renaming Emerson Park. Lots of great suggestions, so thank you guys so much. I think in the end, I really like the suggestion by Anna Johnson to name it Oak Park. It is just brutally simple, but it also references the actual, you know, features of the park. And we did kind of decide to pick this massive oak placed in the very center of it. So simplicity is winning out this time. I think it's a great reference. It's also very close to this suggestion by Drew Weber, so I think I can kind of combine the two. The official name is Oak Park, but amongst locals here in Fort John, you're usually just meeting someone at Big Tree Park. As for Inner Winter, there were plentiful of awesome suggestions as well. I think the 5-point suggestion by Maxwell really has a nice ring to it. You guys really seem to like it as well. It might not be the most New England-y thing to call it, but I mean, we're willing to kind of bend the rules a bit. So I'm just gonna call it 5-point. It's a reference to the kind of 5-angled park here in the very center, Oak Park, as we just named it. Now, this kind of leads me to the point of me naming a winter relatively quickly. And winter is like an official district, so it's like an official, I don't know, postal zip code, you'd probably say, while 5-point is like a more unofficial way of, you know, of designating the western part of winter. But the winter name came a little quick for me, so if you guys have any suggestions for what to actually call this official large part of Fort John, then I'm open to suggestions as well. I think that's gonna be it for naming things for now, and we need to get back to building stuff. Now the question is whether we continue filling out Coleridge now, or we build some more jobs, some workplaces somewhere else. Let's let the statistics be the driver of that. So once again, we move in here and we check jobs, and we can see that we finally surpassed 12,000 jobs here in East Haven County. But the important part, of course, is our unemployed figure, and that has been steadily rising throughout this episode so far. Our population has increased as well, so we're nearing 2,500, which is a little much, I think, compared to the population and the amount of jobs we have. So let's build some more jobs before we finish up Coleridge. Now, I know I mentioned building out this area, getting started with it, but I kind of want to like have like a master idea for it, because it's going to be a truly massive industrial area. So I think I'm going to fill in some of the empty pockets with some workplaces before we get going with the port here. We have this area here, which if you recall from the previous episode, we made sure to build a lane in here so that we could eventually extend it if we wanted to squeeze in just a bit more industrial development or an office or two on this very, very interesting hill squeezed in between the heavy infrastructure here. So I think we might just do that. But something I think would be pretty cool would be trying to just kind of complete this railway intersection here. So I'm going to grab, we're going to grab this two-way train track, and then I kind of want to make a connection here as well. So let's just select the symbol curve mode. I'll find this node here, and then we'll move down to about here. It doesn't have to be like a specifically 180 degrees. 177 will do. 2.8% grade. It's a little much for freight, but I think we can kind of bend the rules here a bit as well. And then I need to connect somewhere in here where it makes sense and it makes a proper connection. So let's just see how this is going to look. I think we're just gonna click here, then we'll grab, move it, grab this node, control H to the height of this node here. Yank. And we might as well just elevate this node as well, just trying to make it a little smoother, just from what we can see, at least something like this. And then we'll do a little inspection as a couple of trains pass by, of course. I think that looks pretty cool. I don't know how realistic something like this would be, but it looks cool. It looks a lot of fun. So we're gonna stick with it. And I think if we can be even a little more wacky, we could have like an old piece of the freight line kind of move into this area here, and then have some industry here that used to use it. I'm not sure it's getting any more use currently, but I think that would be a lot of fun. So I kind of need to branch off from around here, I think. So we'll just make a bit of a tight turn here, and I definitely need to make sure I don't have a ton of elevation going on. 1.4 we can do with that. So I'll just click, and then I'll just have a straight segment as well. And I think I might need to do a bit of terraforming to actually make this fit, make it look all right. We'll grab the level terrain tool, make it a little smaller, grab this level here, and then I'm just going to kind of flatten this out. Something like this. And then I think I have a dual train track, which is good for a rail yard setup, something like this maybe, where the tracks are brought real close to each other, so it's like a really narrow segment. Yep, that's pretty good. And while we're likely gonna turn this into like an overgrown, unused segment, as we discussed, I still do need a bit of industry to kind of face it, right? So we're gonna do a little more terraforming here. I had hoped I didn't have to do this much, but this is pretty tricky terrain to get an old freight line in. And then we'll grab the type of road we've used here, if I can, because I have so much decal use. There we go. And we'll disable snapping, and I'm just gonna try and get like a straight segment to move back here. Actually, we're just gonna try and follow the terrain just a little bit, then connect down here. Can we do like this? 11%? I think that's all right. We do need to kind of smoothen things out a bit though, so that it looks a little more natural than it is. And now we should be able to squeeze in a few workplaces here. So it's not gonna be anything major, like we don't have the space, right? But it's gonna help with our unemployment issue either way. So let's bring up the menu here. We're going for industry, of course, and let's just say the depth can be free at max because we don't have all that much space, right? Industrial manufacturing. Actually, I kind of want that to be aligned to the train tracks. I think that would look better. There you go. See if we can grab something else. This is more warehousey. Maybe we need, actually, we could go for like a warehouse type development here, I think. Something like this. We'll leave this empty, add in a surface, maybe some props. My question is whether we can be cheeky and squeeze in like a tiny old industrial lot on the other side of the road here. Maybe something that's been abandoned. Something like this, maybe. I think I can add this, and I can give it like an abandoned look, I think. So of course for us, it's still functional, it provides jobs, but we can remove some props and add a ton of like stains and graffiti, make it look real abandoned. Might even be able to squeeze this one in as well. Yeah, I think we're gonna need to upgrade this highway segment here to have a key wall like that. And then district wise, I mean, I guess technically this would be part of the official district of Winter, although Winter, or whatever we name it in the future, is turning out to be quite a sizable district by now. So we may break it up further in the future into several official districts. For now though, it's pretty sizable. And then in here, I did want some of this to look a little abandoned, so we'll grab a better bulldozer, get rid of some of this stuff here, the signage at the very least, and then it's just a matter of making it look really, really messy. So we can, of course, grab some of our lovely decals. I mean, that does look pretty grimy, I think. Let's get the rest of this detailed all up. it looks nice. I'm pretty happy with how it turned out, and it did add some jobs, but not nearly the numbers I had envisioned. I'm not really sure what I was imagining. It's a bunch of small warehouses and a no longer used freight line. So I think I'll be developing some more over here. We have this very interesting little area here where I think we can squeeze in some more industry, and we're gonna try and move relatively quick this time around. Just get more jobs in here. It's not necessarily a placeholder area. I mean, it's probably gonna look all right, but it's just not something I'm gonna spend too much time working on. So what we'll just be doing here is pretty much just adding a very basic road layout. Can look a little chaotic and messy. That's even a positive, actually. So we'll just add some lanes and stuff, add weird angles, and then we'll just prepare to do the groundworks here, move in and remove the crossings here. Don't think we'll be needing that. And yeah, let's bring up find it. We could zone, but you know, the industrial assets, I kind of like getting to pick what I actually want to use, you know. So there's a 4 tiles deep up here. So let's just select that and maybe go for like some warehousey type stuff, which I think we can kind of stack some of these together as well, so that looks like a single unit, especially with the recolor mod, where we can easily make it have the complete the same colors, make it look real uniform. So let's just get something like that in. Do we have a bit of oil here, maybe, just to make it a little interesting? I think we do, although we are gonna have a fully dedicated oil port, I think, here in East Haven County. I don't know how realistic that is for a Massachusetts-based city like that, but it's a very interesting, visual. Like, aesthetically, it's very, very interesting. So that's why I want to make it somewhere here in East Haven. But let me just see if I can find, like, a proper big industrial asset to kind of place here. And I don't really mind that there are some parking and just some like empty surface areas as part of these. Actually, I prefer it because it's going to reduce my need for adding parking lots. Oh, I need to pause here because I'm having some utility issues. Makes sense because it's only connected to some highway stretches that, of course, don't really have any electricity or water underneath. Let's just see if we can get in an industrial manufacturing building here on this corner and get a few more of these placed. So I know that we have a limited amount of assets in Cities Skylines 2 currently, and that we're really, really looking forward to have some more, of course. But with that said, I'm really impressed by the quality of the vanilla assets, and I'm very, very excited about the future with the asset editor, especially with how easy it is to add paths and props and whatnot to kind of make your prefabs or your assets add additional variety and stuff to them. But anyways, we have quite a few jobs out here now, I would hope. At least, can we get in a big parking lot? We can. Just get that added in here, and then we'll see how much surface work we need to do. Well, that's not too bad, actually. So I can hopefully just expand the surfaces of some of these existing buildings. And once again, I kind of like this look where, just like we did, let's see, up here, where we have, you know, some empty space on the lots here. I know that it's not necessarily the most realistic. You know, I imagine that when this lot was put for sale, you probably bought all of it. I'm not sure. Maybe there was like a policy that some of it, when it's industrial development, some of it should just be left to kind of grow to maybe balance out things a little. But that also sounds very progressive. So that's probably just, you know, my own thinking here. Kind of taking over, but I imagine something like that would be nice at least. Anyways, I'm gonna place a few more buildings, and then I think we're gonna call it. So we'll get one more building down here, See if I can angle it a little oddly here by the end of the road. And that's about it. I've brought in some sewage, fresh water and electricity. I'm just gonna make it a district as well so that we can actually provide some service coverage for this area. And then it's a matter of seeing just how simple we can keep all the detailing. Alright, so I have connected the district up to some city firehouse and recycling center service, so things don't burn down and we're able to collect the garbage as well. I've connected it all up to utilities and I have named it Low Plain because this area is sort of a low-lying plain. It's relatively flat compared to most of the island, so that's about where my creativity goes. But otherwise, I'm pretty happy with the detailing level. Pretty simple stuff, a few props here and there, and then a lot of these boulders and bushes. Very happy how this turned out. But one thing is the aesthetics, another thing is the functionality, and I think we'll see in excess of 500 jobs out here when all these buildings start filling in, so that's really nice. A great little addition. 500 jobs isn't exactly going to eradicate our unemployment issue, but it's definitely making a bit of a dent in it, and I think we're jumping into developing the rest of Coalridge now, and we have to remember there are going to be plenty of jobs here as well, because there's going to be a lot of mixed use. There's going to be some commercial, some office. There's probably going to be more housing, so it is going to raise unemployment levels, at least percentage wise, a bit. But yeah, I mean, we don't We don't have all that much space to work with anymore, which is only making this task easier, because the tricky thing with these density transition areas is to, you know, decide where are you gonna have your clusters of medium density, where are you gonna have your lower densities. I think in the case of Coleridge, it's a little easier because the remaining triangle of open lots we have here is completely flanked by two major roads and one very prominent road where, you know, real estate is probably pretty expensive. So one of these is Fawn Street, which I think I'm just gonna name Oak Avenue instead. And that's not how you spell Avenue, so we'll go for Oak Avenue. And then I think just to enable some oaks here, or some sort of tree at least, I am going to just upgrade it so it has this median in the very center. There we go. And the other main street we have here is Cozy Street, which cuts through most of Fort John. And I want to name this something a little more eclectic maybe. So maybe we'll go for Queen's Passage, something like that, just so it's a little more personalized. And then the third road I was talking about is, of course, Lilac Street, which, you know, it follows the bay here. And it's also where we see up here in 5 points, the 5 point section of Windsor, that we have some pretty high developments here because this is obvious, very nice property. You have fantastic views of this open bay. So we'll also have medium density alongside Lilac Street here, although we should probably call this Bay Road. Yeah, man, that's very creative. I think it will do for now. But basically, our tactic is kind of set in stone for us now. Then we are going to find it, and we're gonna go through some of the medium density stuff we want, and we're gonna line that alongside Oak Avenue, Queen's Passage, and Bay Road. The practical approach is just the same as with Windsor, which means that I'm going to ask for North American medium buildings for starters at least. And then one thing I like to filter on early on is basically just building level. And, you know, there's like a general theme that the higher building level, the older, more prestigious buildings are gonna look. That's not always the case for whatever reason, but it's the case most of the time. And I think these buildings down here, they really showcase what it is I mean. So some of these, for instance, are obviously fantastic buildings that you could see facing Central Park in Manhattan, you know, as part of the Upper West or East Side. They are very, very bulky though. So I have to be careful with how many of these I place out here, because they're also kind of distinct. So it's limited how many times I can place the same building without it being very obvious. And we do need some very fancy buildings here in downtown Fort John, where we will have the highest density, of course. So I'm gonna grab some of these that look a little more generic and try to get them placed. We have some of these mixed use as well, which are absolutely beautiful, but we might as well see if we can squeeze in a bit of that. And I think the block here between Bay Road and Oak Avenue, right next to downtown, could potentially be one of the more dense blocks we built here in Coleridge, so we might as well just make sure that this corner here in particular is very well developed. And I'm going to extensively squeeze buildings together to quote-unquote create, you know, custom designs, because that is, of course, one way in which we can kind of continue reusing the same buildings and make sure that they look a little more unique. And with the recolor mod, it's fairly easy for us to make sure that they look similar. So in this case, they spawn with pretty much the same color and look like one single building. So that's perfect. I don't have to do anything, but normally I'd have to recolor them. The block right next door, I also imagine to be quite developed. So we'll add these beautiful old buildings. These are also mixed use. So we will see some establishments rent the storefronts on street level, which is really nice. We get two of these placed. And we're moving a bit further down Oak Avenue to add this beautiful building. In this case, it's a high density commercial building, actually. I might remove the signs, but I like the overall design. It has this old American vibe to it. I did go a little heavy on these level fives here. It's maybe a little more dense than I had initially imagined. So I am dropping down to level four just to grab some buildings that physically are smaller, and they're also just less fancy to actually look at. And as we reach these final outermost blocks here on Cold Ridge, I'm even tempted to grab a bit of row housing, get that placed in here as well. We'll go for level 5, North American. Actually, let's just go for any of the themes so that I can pick some of these older European ones as well, if that's what I want. I think they could fit in, you know, given the age of the developments we're seeing in this general area here. So I'll just try to have a bit of a mix, really. So since we have a limited amount of like mixed use assets available, I like to kind of create my own by fusing together some medium density housing with some low density commercial. So I'm going to do that at several places just to create a bit of a more unique look. But things are still turning out a little more dense than I had anticipated. So we'll probably just go for a few medium density buildings here alongside this segment of Oak Avenue and Queen's Passage. And then I'm going to try and squeeze in some lower density commercials, some row houses, and maybe even a bit of, you know, a small park or something in here. But I'm gonna slap on some music and get going with it, because I think you know my techniques by now. That was quite the building session, but Coleridge is all but done now. I've segmented it into a smaller unofficial neighborhood here called Bay's End, which carries the majority of the residents here in the Coleridge area. And that took a long time, but I was pretty confident that I wouldn't be able to really get a good result from zoning with this layout here. The street layout is just a little too chaotic. So yeah, manually placing every single building is just gonna take a lot of time, especially when I want each block to be slightly unique. And I think we've achieved that. So we have a bit of open space in here where we have the, what is this? This was the Fort John Children's Musical School, which is sort of connected to a small park as well. So it's a bit of, there's a bit of an open area here surrounded by medium density stuff. But otherwise, just a lot of experimentation, stitching some buildings together. Some of it I'm not too pleased with, but once again, you know, it's kind of a trade-off. This could take several more hours if I want everything to be perfect. So I think I'm going to aim for good enough, especially since we are not done plopping here in Fort John. We need all of downtown, which, I mean, size-wise is much bigger than Coleridge and probably bigger than Winter as well. So lots of additional plopping ahead is what I'm trying to say. But other than that, I'm pretty happy with how it looks, especially as we kind of zoom out and grab some views up here from the interstate, up here from the Cemetery Hill. It looks, you know, you can really see that we don't have a strict road grid here at play because the buildings are different angles and just it looks very nice, I think. So if we have a look at our statistics panel, we see that the completion of Coleridge has brought us near 14,000 jobs here in East Haven County, but I think the unemployment rate has actually, it's kind of settled at around 2,000, which is quite surprising. But I guess there's actually a pretty healthy ratio between, yeah, there's like a 1-to-3 ratio between the amount of jobs and the amount of residents here in Bay's End. So that's all right. It's not too bad. I don't have to panic about adding more jobs right now, but it is of course going to be a continued focus onwards. But I think that's it. There's one final thing we can do because our financial situation has improved massively with the addition of all this new housing and additional businesses. So we are actually able to repay our loan. Because we do have a loan we took early on with an interest rate of 2.8. So we should be able to easily just repay that, and that reduced our expenses a bit. Cost us 300k, but we have the cash, so why not? Anyways, I'm gonna jump into some final cinematics, but we are gonna do some first person walking, I think, around Bay's End as well, which I hope you guys will enjoy. You certainly liked it in the previous episode, and I guess there's nothing more to say than thank you guys so much. I hope it's become very obvious how much I appreciate all the feedback and all the suggestions. You guys are helping me name cities, name districts, plan out stuff. It's just fantastic to be a part of. But yeah, that's a wrap. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye.